Sport has the power to unite people. The heroes are standing with me are examples of this power. They are valiant, not only in the playing field, but also in the community. They are champions.
Somewhat tribal aspect to sport. We get behind our teams and join in mass celebration for their victories. Sport has the ability to unite nations, bring people together and put an end to conflicts. In 2005, the Ivory Coast was in the midst of a civil war. The country was split in two, with a rebel-held north and a government-held south. Over 200 government soldiers, 300 rebel troops, and 1,200 civilians died in the conflicts. Its football team was playing in Sudan for its first ever spot in the World Cup. With an entire nation watching anxiously, the team led by international football star Didier Drogba defeated the Sudanese squad, providing hope for his home country. After the contest, Drogba spoke to his countrymen through the media, imploring them to lay down their arms and hold elections. Sure enough, within weeks, a ceasefire was agreed and both sides came together to negotiate. It shows how the game of football can unite the people and bring hope for a better future. Sport has also helped ease tensions between nations. During the height of the Cold War in the 1970s, a small encounter between two ping pong players helped bridge a massive divide. In 1971, American ping pong player Glenn Cohen was late for his team's bus at the World Championships. He hopped on the Chinese bus instead and struck up a conversation with the Chinese team's best player. The two became friendly and exchanged gifts. It led to Chairman Mao inviting the Americans to play in China. The Chinese players had arrived at the 1971 championships with strict orders to avoid contact with the Americans. Upon learning of the gift exchange, Chairman Mao took it as a political opportunity. A few days later, the US team were preparing to leave Nagoya. Mao shocked the world by inviting them to make an all-expense-paid visit to China. The ripple effects of what has become known as ping-pong diplomacy only continued the following year. In response to the American trip, the Chinese sent their table tennis team to the United States for an 8-city tour. Even more earth-shattering was Richard Nixon's February 1972 visit to the People's Republic, which marks the first time in history that an American president had travelled to the Chinese mainland. As part of the 8-day trip, Nixon would call it the week that changed the world. The president met with Chairman Mao and took the first steps towards normalising US-Chinese relations. The goodwill ultimately led to official diplomatic relations between the two countries.
Sport has the power to change the world. It has the power to inspire. It has the power to unite people in a way that little us does. It speaks to youth in a language they understand. Sport can create hope where once there was only despair. It is more powerful than governments in breaking down racial barriers. It laughs in the face of all types of discrimination. The heroes are standing with me are examples of this power. They are valiant, not only in the playing field, but also in the community, both local and international. They are champions, and they deserve the world's recognition.
Like that!
That is some serious power!
Wow!
And it is-